Hi, Ed Friedland, the Bass Whisperer here, taking a close-up look at the new Genzbenz Shuttle Max 9.2. The 9.2 is the logical extension of the Shuttle Max series, which features the Shuttle Max 6.0, which is a 600 watt amp, and the Shuttle Max 12.0, which is two separate 600 watt modules in the same casing. Ever since Genzbenz came out with their great Shuttle 9.0, which was a 900 watt digital power amp, everyone was like, hey, when are we going to see a 900 watt Shuttle Max? And here it is. The 9.2 is pretty much like the other Shuttle Max amps with a few differences. The most obvious thing, of course, is the front panel is painted black like the Shuttle 9.0. But the same features of the Max platform are all here. We've got two channels, one FET, one tube driven. Both of them have high and low gain switches. There's shelving, bass and treble controls, and then two bands of semi-parametric mid-range. We've got three variable filters, bass boost, mid-cut, and high-frequency attack, all controllable via foot switch. Channel switching is also accessible via foot switch, as well as the ability to mix the channels together. Two important differences in the Shuttle Max 9.2 are the inclusion of FAT, which is P-H-A-T, stands for Proprietary Heat Abatement Technology, and 3DPM, which is 3-Dimensional Power Management. From what I understand, one of the big issues with digital Class D power amps is managing the heat buildup. And to get above the 600 watt mark, Genzbenz found it was necessary to devise some sort of scheme for managing heat buildup in the unit, and that's what they call PHAT. 3DPM is a new development that was just introduced in the brand new Genzbenz Streamliner series. Essentially, it's a limiting circuit that focuses mainly on the low frequencies that tend to push the amp into clipping, and it allows the highs to come through relatively untouched. The goal of this is to create that dimensional feel that a tube amplifier gives you when you start pushing on it. This is a new development for the Shuttle Max series. This 9.2 is the first of the Shuttle Max and Shuttle series amps to feature that. Let's twiddle around with the knobs on the Shuttle Max 9.2. I'm on the FET channel in low gain mode and the controls are set completely flat. I've got a slight bass boost and a slight treble boost on the onboard preamp. Here's the slap tone. Now, one thing I always like to do with my Shuttle amps is I roll the bass up a tiny bit, maybe 1 or 2 o'clock. I take the first mid-range control and I put it all the way down to 120, and then I boost that to about 1 or 2 o'clock as well. Now let's listen. Really plumps it up nicely. I can add a little bit of treble on top of that. Really brings the sparkle out. Me personally, I almost never use that second mid-range control because I find that the amp pretty much sounds the way I want it to sound. But if you want it, that second mid-range control is there. Let's hear the sweep. It ranges from 300 Hz to 5K. Now let's listen to the tube channel. Again, the controls are set completely flat and I'm in low gain mode. Slap tone. I'm going to do my little bass boost and my low mid boost, a little bit of a treble boost, tiny bits. Sure Sure sounds great. Around back, we've got a full feature set, including a direct balanced line out with ground lift switch, pre or post EQ, and line or mic level switches. There's a line level auxiliary input, which allows you to play another audio source through the amp, for example, if you want to practice with your MP3 player. There's a dedicated tuner output, which is also active when the mute switch is engaged. We've got three effects loops, master, tube channel, and FET channel. There's a connection for the included foot switch, as well as another input to connect a mute switch. And then we have the headphone output. The Shuttle Max 9.2 has two speak-on type speaker connectors. The amp is capable of going down to a 4-ohm load where you get the full 900 watts. You get 500 watts into 8 ohms. Another handy feature on all Gensbenz Shuttle amps is the voltage selector, which allows you to go from 115 to 220 volts, a very good feature if you're traveling around the world. You can hear subtle differences between the tube and FET channels. I'd say that the FET is a little bit more open and a little airy on top, a little more pristine. The tube definitely colors the sound. I think it darkens it up a little bit, introduces some harmonic material in the kind of upper mid-range zone. And of course, with the variable gain structure on the amp, you can push the level of the tube independently of the overall volume of the amp, so you can actually use the tube almost as a tone control. For example, right now on the tube channel, I've got the gain set at 11 o'clock and the channel volume set at about 1 o'clock. So here's the tone on that. I'm going to try to keep the overall volume about the same. I'm going to drop the channel volume and push the tube a little bit harder. You can hear that it sort of plumps up a bit and darkens the overall tone. I'm going to drop the channel volume all the way down to the very minimum and push the tube all the way. Now with the high and low gain switch, we can add a whole lot of gain to this tube. Let's pop that in. I'm going to keep the channel volume low. As you can hear, it pushes that tube into an overdrive situation. It's not going to sound like an SVT, but it's a gritty sound. It adds a lot of character, and on its own, it's a very warm kind of brown tone. It works really nice when you mix it with the solid state channel. Let's check that out. First, here's the overdriven tube by itself. Now I'm going to blend in the FET channel. This is all accessible via foot switch, by the way. As you can tell, the blending of the two channels keeps that essential clean tone there. And then, you know, you can mix and blend the two channels any way you want. Of course, with the two bands of parametric mid-range, you can really tailor the sound on the overdriven tube channel. Let's mess with that a little bit. I'm going to mess with the upper mids. Lower mids a little bit. Mm-hmm. pretty gnarly. Another nice thing about the high and low gain switches is it allows you to really tailor the input gain for active or passive instruments. I'm going to put the bass in passive mode right now, roll the treble down just a tiny bit, and you'll hear we can still get a really nice warm tube overdriven sound. With the introduction of the new Streamliner series, there's been a lot of discussion back and forth about Streamliner versus Shuttle Max and Shuttle series amps. What I'll say is that they're two completely different animals with two different sonic signatures. The Streamliner, when you turn that on and put everything at 12 o'clock, you're already hearing sort of a sculpted tone. There's low frequency extension, there's a real sweetness to the top end, and when you start pushing that amp, it really gives you a very good representation of how a tube amp will respond. The Shuttle Max series, however, when you turn this thing on and you put everything at 12 o'clock, you're hearing a relatively neutral, relatively uncolored sound, which I feel really lets the sound of the instrument shine through with very little influence from the amplifier. Of course, with this much flexibility in the EQ section, we've got bass and treble shelving controls, two bands of parametric mids, three variable filter sweeps. You can point this amp pretty much in any direction you want. With the tube and solid state channels, you have two completely different tones on tap, and the ability to blend the two is a great feature. The Shuttle Max 9.2 gives you 900 watts into a 4-ohm load, 500 watts into 8 ohms. It's light, it's loud, it's powerful, it's flexible, it's awesome.